This is January 1st, 2020. Happy New Year. Which also means that I haven't driven this car in exactly 1 year. I was just going through the logs, and for whatever reason, I don't know why, I just haven't. The last time I drove this car was January 1st, 2019. And it's just been sitting under the cover here in the shop, kind of in this corner, which is a shame because this is the best driving car I have. This is a 1929 Ford Model A. It's all original. Original factory paint, factory interior, never been restored. And it drives better than this car and this car, which have been restored. It's a beautiful driving car, but I just never drive it. So, it's a sunny day, sort of. It looks kind of sunny, yeah. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get this car and this car out, and I'm gonna uncover this car, check all the fluids, kind of sort of dust it off. And since I need to go to the store to get some things, I'm going to drive that car to the store. Original factory paint, but it still has gloss, as you can see. I've done quite a bit of rubbing. Now the seats, I have blankets on them. The original cloth is in fantastic condition. I don't want it damaged. So both the front and the back seats, I have blankets covering the cloth. I have plastic on the carpet. The floor mat is replaced. It didn't have a floor mat when I got the car. And door is shut like a bank vault. It's just fantastic. The engine is still the original. Although I did take the original fan off and put this reproduction fan because the original fans have a problem with coming apart and flying through the hood. I still have the original fan, so no worries. The motor has been rebuilt though at 68,000 and some change. The main Babbitt bearing splattered. It was very unfortunate. But I just had the same engine rebuilt, put insert bearings in it, and all is good. It always, always runs like a watch. Never any trouble with this car. Of course, I say that now just before we do a cold start on it. But this car has always just, from the day I got it and rebuilt the carburetor, distributor, did some things just because it sat forever. And just one day I just thought, oh, what the heck, I'll just see if it'll start. And it started right up, and it's just always run perfect. And it drives perfect. It doesn't wander all over. It doesn't bounce around. It's just silky glass smooth down the road like a modern car. It's really amazing. But something happens when you restore them. They lose something. So they're only original once. And this one is still original. It's been to Concours twice. One Concours D Elegance. It was photographed, actually. It appeared in the Hemmings Model A calendar. I guess it was 3 years ago. Two Concours D Elegance wins. Got best in class and best unrestored at Concours D Elegance. So not too many unrestored cars that still look like this. But you know how everybody's all into these cold start videos? Well, I guess a year of sitting is cold enough, so let's give it a cold start. With any Model A that's been sitting for a while, it's a good idea to lube the distributor before you start it. This one has the drilled center shaft. Not original, but it sure is helpful. And then make sure to lube the distributor cam. I use Super Lube, which works very well. It doesn't get thin when it gets hot. It's excellent for... Put a little on the distributor cam there. Now we're ready to start. meter shows it's charging. That's good. It's been running for a few minutes here. I can probably idle it down. And there it is, out in the daylight. First time in a year it's seen daylight. Sun actually kind of shines off of it a little bit. Kind of a lot of work to take the paint back to where it should be here. It was pretty dirty, but when I first got it, I made sure not to remove any paint. It's already had enough rub spots on it, so I had to be very, very careful when cleaning this paint. All right, let's go to the store. Put it away for another year. A little more fuel stabilizer, and see you next year.